why. So once again, I just to show actually what you have to do. Right. The case is different, and right. So what I say, the confidentiality test is at least two cases, the HIV and Huntington. Then I'd like to train yourself so that then you say the word of confidentiality starting your discussion. But not so many times that confidentiality. Alright? Three times, confidentiality. All are confidential. What is this? Are you confidential? But I love to hear this word of confidentiality because I wanted to do so. You say confidentiality, no worries. At least you don't miss it. Alright? Fine. So, hi, Mr. Fine, right? So you are 36 years old. I'm going to sound as if in this danger. Alright, so my consultant actually has asked me to discuss actually what happened to you and some of the things actually you have to do after that, after the discussion. So people start with me, I'd like to know actually how much do you understand about the illness that happened?
Well, doctor, for the past few weeks I've been suffering from this respiratory breathing difficulties. And my GP has given me a lot of, as I understand, a lot of medications, and none of this has been helping me. And then a couple of days back, I developed this rash all over my body. And I guess it was an infection in my throat as well. And now I've got a severe pain in my throat. And since he couldn't treat me further, he asked me to come see you.
Oh, this is about the highness, right? All right. Is there anybody else from our medical team actually have discussed anything else? Regarding the chest infection that you acquired.
No, you're the first person I'm talking to today.
I'm sorry if you're suffering about infection as well as the chest infection. Alright, so the thing actually, the concern actually, why I'm here actually today, my consultant asked me to take some of the important history, which is very important, to reach your diagnosis. Because the main concern, the infarction in your chest, in your lungs, that happen, that is, we call not a general or typical varieties of bugs that infect you, right? It's a different varieties of bugs, which is rarely seen in a normal person with a good immune function.
That's a good thing for me. You're telling me that I'm doing all of this. My immune system is not working properly.
That may be a possibility, sir. Actually, the thing happens, this kind of infections, you cannot be happy in a normal person. With the person having the immune function is working very, very well. Alright. So, we suspect the infection that happened to you, alright, it happens to that person, alright, when the immune function is not working well.
Yes, I mean, I've been wondering why this, the medications weren't working properly because of the same reason.
So the thing is that actually immune function is not working when a person like you are 36, right? So in such ways, the immune function is not working well. The reason, not so actually, but we suspect the infection, one of the important infection that reducing the strength of immunity with the immune function to such extent that the impact in your chest will happen. That is the pneumonia that we call it. Right? Sometimes it happens that some persons having the infection, immune function is not working well. In such a child group or children group of patients, they have some of the varieties of immune function not working, they inherited from their parents or inborn disease or something like that. But as you suspect in young adult, you had a very good life before that, right? And you acquired some infection that does really essentially mean that your immune function is not working.
Is
that
all right?
It is.
How do I go forward? I mean, your medications are not working. How's that going to help me now?
All right. So, literally, we are talking that the infection happened to you, important infection that is called the HIV. What does the literally means that immune human immunodeficiency virus. It's such a virus that I understand that I can guess that you heard about the virus,
yes.
MRI.
Yes.
So this virus is particularly reducing the immune function. That's the virus name itself, so, like HIV.
So you think I have HIV?
We are suspecting, right? My concern is suspecting, right? Because of this atypical infection that happened to your chest, as well as the infection in your throat, that is, we call the candidiasis. So these two things actually gives us a clue to that your immune function is not working well in this one. And that is the reason that HIV is the first one which can reduce your immune function.
That's a lot to take in. I mean, I never considered
that. I'm sorry, sir. One
I
second.
I have HIV, and it's a shock, actually.
I'm sorry, once again. Alright. Would you like two, alright, if I continue?
Yeah, please.
Actually, there are a lot of things to discuss, alright? Mm-hmm. So, I'd like to ask so many personal questions, actually, alright? Maybe a bit of discomfort may you feel, alright? Not maybe so much comforted with that. But I must ask them. But before saying that, or asking these questions, I would like to say the things. Whatever you are discussing, the things that are strictly confidential.
I hope so. I really hope so.
Yes. Right. So tell me, sir, how do you have any sexual partners?
I have a stable partner. Yes, we've been living together for the last 5 years.
Single partner.
Single.
No other else.
Well, I don't know if you. I hope that this will be confidential.
Yes, this must be, this is confidential. That's right, actually before starting the discussion, I'd like to say.
Me and a couple of friends usually go off to visit Southeast
Asia. Means
Southeast Asia.
The main partners?
Friends, just a couple of friends. I'm not homosexual.
Oh.
I am a straight guy, and me and a couple of mates usually go to Bangkok, and from time to time, we have encounters over there.
Alright, so it does mean that you have some sex with the prostitutes?
Well, I have never paid anybody for sex, but I do have friend or other separate partners over there. Whenever I go, I usually hook up.
But you have not the sex with the prostitutes?
Not that anymore.
That's fair. Right. So tell me about your partners again. You have got the status of each other. Actually, why I'm asking this important question, because I would like to know what is the source that you may contract the virus this reason and why is the source actually, right?
Well,
that's why actually I'm asking this question.
I'm trying to think of it myself as well, that probably some of my friends over there use recreational drugs. That's also a possibility, and I have also used it. Not
sharing needles, alright. So do you know if your friends are HIV positive, any of the status of that?
The last encounter was like 2 months back.
2 months back?
Yeah, we just came back from Bangkok.
Oh, after coming back with any problems?
That's when the problem started. Oh,
this problem.
This problem started.
Sorry, sir, once again, right. Actually, the things actually after teaching history that I've got important, right? Your partner. And the source or may not be, we don't know. All right. So, another important issue is that I need to tell you, right? So, we need to test you for the HIV test. What do you think about it? Are you going to do the test?
Well, now come to think about it, since I've had taken the drugs as well as being with actually people I don't know.
Maybe so that may be the reason, right?
I think it would be prudent for me to take the test.
Yes.
So what do you think of that?
Yes, we need to do the test, otherwise, you know, the thing is that HIV, actually the treatment and the diagnostic and also the proof of efforts, it has been changed dramatically to the things actually we did from the medical side, the team is back. And nowadays, HIV person with treatment means they need even their minimum life. have a very good treatment sometimes. So the thing is so necessary to diagnose as early as possible. You can start the treatment immediately after that. So that's the important issue that I have.
If I'm positive, you're taking or just taking my blood today?
Yes, yes.
What if I'm negative? Do these tests are correlated if I'm negative?
The thing is that, right? As I say, the infections, the test of infection, and also these things, we are suspecting that you should have the HIV positive. So the person having the high risk, of course, right, that the high risk will contract the HIV virus infection. So we do the test after the 2 weeks. We do this one, right, to confirm it once again. And actually the thing is that we take the blood, right, we see the antibody of the HIV. Alright. So sometimes it can be negative. Right? It takes time to develop. So sometimes, alright, the sample will take blood, we get the antibody. In that case also we are getting negative. But we have some of the special tests. Or maybe we can wait for the 2 weeks to do the same test once again.
And what do I do between, if I'm negative, God forbid, if I am negative, if I'm lucky, I'll be negative. If I am negative, what do I do for the next 2 weeks before you test me again? Because of this, I'm having problems with these, and that's my concern.
We have the treatments, right? We have the treatments for your infections, right? We give the stuff, very good treatment. We can monitor your infection, the test, and also.
Do I need to be a little treated like this?
Oh, right. So,
GP gave me a lot of antibiotics that didn't actually work.
So that's fine. You get a bit in the hospital. You have to be convenient for a few days. You can start the treatment, monitor you, right? And within the day, it's possible to get the HIV test comes positive or negative. So we can actually decide on that. Because it came from a long distance.
Do I need to tell my partner that I'm getting admitted because of these things and what you're suspecting?
Yes. The answer is yes. You need to inform your partner. Is there any confusions about informing your partner?
Well, I just wanted to keep it down until I actually get the results. But since you're saying that I have to be admitted, I have to tell her that I'll be admitted. She's very worried about why these things are happening to me. Does she need to be admitted to be checked for the
first of all that actually you need to inform your partner. You want to have sex, so you have to do some of the safe sex, using the protection, right? Before the condom, right? You have to use that. And you have to deal with the partner. And at this moment actually you're not suspecting your partner has no symptom, but we do the test as well to trace the contact. So that will be fine.
Right. So once I get the test results, she will come in and get the
test. You do counseling if you feel that. If your partner also feels that, then it needs to be counseled. So you have the infectious disease patient and also the counselor. So they will be really appropriate person to discuss all these issues together. Is it all?
Yes, it is.
So somebody is that actually. I'm sorry actually to tell something. Things and maybe you all of a sudden that you got a shock that you've got the HIV infection. But the fact is that it's a positive. So I need to say to you all. And I hope that you will agree to go for the test.
Yes, please.
And the second important issue is that we need to inform your partner. And the third important issue is that I and if you need some more information, right? So if you get the right, to provide some information, right? You can read it out.
Thank you. Is it all right? Yes, thank you very much. I'm just waiting for you to tell me the results.
So what I do now, I take the sample of the blood to send it for the test, and immediately after getting the test results back in hands, I inform myself for it.
Right, thank you.
Thank you. Done.
Okay. Summarize.
All right, I summarize. So what? Is it appropriate? Whatever you have seen. Sometimes the form is changing by your hands. All right. Clear. Happy.
Very good, sir.
Excellent.